segundo libro de Samuel.
Second book of Samuel, chapter 15.
Versículo 1.
Verse 1.
En adelante.
Further.
Y yo solamente les voy a leer el primer versículo.
We're going to read from verse 1.
Que dice de la manera siguiente.
And it reads this way.
Aconteció después de esto que Absalón se hizo de carros y caballos y 50 hombres que corriesen delante de él.
In the course of time, Absalom provided himself a chariot, horses, and 50 men to run ahead of him.
Hemos tomado hoy en esta tarde la historia de David.
So today we're going to base our scripture on the story of David.
Aunque el pasaje que leímos comienza con su hijo Absalón.
Although the passage we read starts with his son Absalom.
Y esta historia de toda ella tiene que ver con David y su familia.
And all the story has to do about something about David and his family.
David en este tiempo tenía quizás algunos 45 años de edad, entre 45 a 40 años de edad.
So we can say that David was about maybe 45 years old or about.
Y David enfrentó muchas situaciones.
And David confronted so many situations.
Como muchas veces nosotros enfrentamos muchas situaciones que la vida nos trae.
As many times we are also confronted with those stories.
Pero cómo nosotros reaccionamos a esas situaciones que enfrentamos en la vida.
But how do we react to those situations that life confronts us with?
¿Cómo nosotros nos comportamos cuando pasamos por problemas?
How do we behave when we confront problems?
Y en esta historia nos muestra cómo David reaccionó frente a aquellos problemas.
So this story tells us how David reacted upon all these problems.
¿Cómo David enfrentó esa situación?
How David confronted all of these problems.
¿Cómo nosotros enfrentamos los problemas?
How do we confront all these problems?
Bueno, haga la conclusión usted.
So go ahead and have this conclusion.
David era un hombre de guerra.
This David was a man and he was a warrior.
David era un hombre poderoso para la guerra.
He was a man that was powerful for war.
Y David a sus 40 años.
So David, when he is about 40 years old.
Era un hombre que ya vivía muy bien.
It was a man that he lived very well.
Él había vencido a todos sus enemigos.
He had defeated all of his enemies.
En otras palabras, David ya estaba viviendo tranquilamente.
So then David was living a very peaceful life.
Pero algo pasó en la familia de David.
But something happened in David's family.
Algo sucedió en el seno de la familia de este hombre.
Something happened in the midst of this family.
Y esto es lo que pasa en la familia de David.
So this is going on in David's family.
Su primer hijo llamado Amón.
His first son by the name of Amon.
Que un día este hombre iba a ser rey en Israel.
Supposedly one day he would become king of Israel.
Este era su primer hijo.
This was his firstborn son.
Y según la tradición,
and according to tradition,
el primer hijo es el que heredaba a su padre.
The first son was the one who's going to take over his kingdom.
Así que este hombre es el que le correspondía heredar el trono de David.
So this man was going to go ahead and take over the kingdom.
Pero este hombre llamado Amón.
But this man by the name of Ammon,
se enamoró de su hermana llamada Tamar.
He fell in love with his sister Tamar.
Y Amón,
and then Ammon,
se insistía y procuraba acostarse con su hermana.
He insisted in trying to take advantage of his sister.
Y un día,
and one day,
Amón fingió estar enfermo.
Ammon pretended that he was very ill.
Planificó Amón que se había enfermado y entonces mandó a llamar a su hermana Tamar.
So then he pretended he was very ill and called upon his sister to come to help him.
Y le dice, dígale a Tamar que me traiga de comer.
He said, please tell my sister Tamar to bring me some food.
Y aquella joven,
so then this lovely young lady,
fue a la casa de Amón.
He went to the house of her brother.
Le llevó la comida a su hermano.
So she went ahead and brought food to him.
Que se estaba haciendo pasar por enfermo.
That was pretending that he was very sick.
Y cuando esta joven entró,
and when this young lady entered,
este hombre la tomó y la violó.
This man took her and raped her.
Y después de haberla violado,
and after he raped her,
la echó de la casa.
He went ahead and threw her out the house.
Este hombre,
this man,
deshonró a su hermana de una manera muy vil.
Dishonored his sister in a very wicked way and evil.
Esto es lo que hizo Amón.
This is what Amon did.
Deshonró a su familia.
He went ahead and dishonored his family.
Deshonró a su hermana.
He went ahead and dishonored his sister.
Deshonró a su padre.
He brought shame to his father.
Ahora bien,
So then,
David se enteró de esto.
So then David was able to find this out.
Pero ¿qué hizo David cuando se enteró que su hijo había violado a su otra hija?
So then what did David do when he found out that his own son had raped his own daughter?
David no hizo nada.
So then David went ahead and did absolutely nothing.
Se olvidó del asunto.
David went ahead and put that behind and forgot about that business.
El jugador contrario.
So then the enemy that was on the other side of the field.
Se puso frente a David.
So he was standing right before David.
Y le metió el gol.
And he scored a goal on David.
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 El hombre aguerrido.
The man who was a warrior.
El hombre violento.
The one who was violent and courageous.
No reaccionó.
He did not react.
De la manera como debía de haber reaccionado.
He didn't react in the way that he was expected to.
Sino que se olvidó del asunto.
But he decided to forget about all that business.
Era su hija.
It was his daughter.
Y ignoró.
And he ignored that.
Lo que había pasado con su hija.
What had happened with his daughter.
¿Qué haría usted, hermano?
What would you do, brother and sister?
¿Usted reaccionaría como
would
yo?
Would you react?
¿Usted al menos llamaría a la policía?
You would at least call the police, wouldn't you?
Pero David era la autoridad, era el rey.
But David had the full authority. He was the king.
Pero se quedó callado.
But he stayed quiet.
A pesar de que se dio cuenta lo que había pasado en la casa de su hijo Amón.
Although he was aware of what had happened in his son's house.
Y Tamar,
so Tamar,
que fue la hija de David violada,
who was the daughter of David who now had been raped,
se va a vivir con su hermano llamado Absalón.
So he now decides to go live with his other brother.
Y Absalón,
so Absalom,
decide que si su padre no hace nada,
he decides that okay, if dad's not going to do anything about this,
con respecto al crimen que ha cometido su hermano Amón,
with respect to the crime that his own brother had done,
él va a actuar.
He said, then I am going to take action.
Pero este hombre esperó.
But this man waited.
Esperó y esperó.
He waited and waited.
Esperó 2 años y nada pasó.
He waited about 2 years and nothing had happened.
David no accionó.
David had no action brought upon.
Pasó el tiempo.
The time went by.
Y Absalón.
So Absalom.
Hizo una fiesta.
He did this great feast and this great party.
Y en esa fiesta,
and in that party,
estaba invitado su padre David.
His father David was invited to come.
Y sus hermanos.
And his brothers were also invited.
Pero a último instante,
but at the last moment,
David decide no ir a la fiesta.
So David decides not to attend the feast.
Sus hermanos llegan a la fiesta.
So then all of the brothers show up.
Y Absalón en esa fiesta.
And then Absalom, within that feast, in that party.
Asesina a su hermano Amón.
He kills his brother.
Otro gol para David.
Another goal that was struck against David.
Absalón le quitó la vida a su hermano.
So Absalom took the life of his brother.
En venganza por lo que había hecho a su hermana.
In revenge for what he had done to his own sister.
Aparte de eso, lo hizo en frente de sus otros hermanos.
Besides the fact, he did it in front of everyone who
y
was there.
Y cuando ellos vieron esta escena o lo que había pasado en esa fiesta,
and when the family saw everything that was going on in this party,
todos ellos que estaban ahí se dispersan.
So everybody who was there just ran out and took off.
Y creen o piensan que Absalón va a tomar el poder, va a tomar el trono de su padre.
So then they now think that Absalom's going to take over and he's going to go ahead and take the kingdom.
Y ellos salen huyendo.
So then they flee, they run away.
Porque tenían miedo que también ellos fueran asesinados por Absalón.
So now they were fearful that Absalom would also kill them.
¿Qué es lo que estaba haciendo Absalón?
What was Absalom actually doing?
Absalón estaba vengando públicamente lo que habían hecho a su hermana.
He was taking revenge publicly and everybody being aware for what they had done to his sister.
En otras palabras, Absalón está haciendo justicia por su propia mano.
So now Absalom is taking justice into his own hand.
Porque su padre David no pudo hacer justicia.
Because his own father was not able to bring judgment on this.
Él tomó la justicia.
So then he took justice into his hand.
Porque su padre no actuó.
Because his father never acted.
Su padre dejó pasar todas las cosas.
His father let everything just go by.
Absalón se va del país.
So then Absalom flees and he leaves this country.
Huye.
He flees.
Y llega a un lugar que se llama Gesur.
And he gets to a country that's known by Jezer.
Que hoy es Siria.
And now it's known as Syria.
El asesinato de su hijo.
So now the crime of his son being killed.
Llegó al oído de David.
So now David's being able to hear of this crime that has happened.
En otras palabras, David se enteró que Amón había sido asesinado por su hermano.
So now David finds out that Amon had been killed by his brother.
Otra vez el dilema.
So again the big dilemma comes about.
¿Qué hizo David cuando escuchó esta noticia?
So what did David do when he heard this news?
No hizo nada, David.
He did nothing again.
Estamos hablando de aquel hombre guerrero.
We're talking about that man who was a warrior.
Que le han violado a su hija.
They have raped his daughter.
Y que no hizo nada.
And he did nothing.
Y ahora su otro hijo mata a Amón.
So now his other son kills Amon.
Y tampoco hace nada.
And he still does nothing.
Pasó el tiempo.
So then the time went by.
Pasaron los años.
The years went by.
Y Absalón regresa.
And then Absalom returns.
Otra vez a Israel.
He comes back to the country of Israel.
Y un capitán del ejército.
And then a captain of the army.
Arregla para que Absalón se quede a vivir en el país.
He arranged everything so Absalom's able to stay to live there.
Y Absalón entra a la ciudad Jerusalén.
So Absalom enters into the city of Jerusalem.
Y ahí vivía David en la ciudad de Jerusalén.
And in the city David was still living there.
Y su hijo que había sido fugitivo regresa hoy a vivir al mismo lugar donde vivía David.
So his son who was a fugitive is now returning to live in the same city where his father lives.
Y pasan los años.
And then the years go by.
Y David.
And David.
No manda a llamar a Absalón.
He does not call his son to come to see him.
Él sabía que estaba en la ciudad.
He knew that his son was living in that city.
Pero no buscó a su hijo.
But he did not seek his son.
Estaban en la misma ciudad.
They were right there in the same city.
Y finalmente,
so then finally,
Absalón se reúne con su padre.
So then Absalom reunites with his father.
Pero en esta reunión que ellos tienen,
but in this meeting, in this reunion that they have,
algo sucede.
Something happens.
Algo pasó en esta reunión.
Something happens in this meeting.
Porque Absalón salió enojado de ese lugar, del palacio.
Absalom left and he was so mad he left the palace.
Salió furioso de ese lugar.
He was furious when he left that place.
Pasaron 4 años después de ese encuentro.
So then 4 years went by after that reunion.
Y durante esos 4 años.
And during those 4 years,
Absalón se sienta a las puertas de la ciudad.
So Absalom sits in the entry of the city.
Y la hace de juez.
And then he sits there and he acts as a judge.
Comenzó a aconsejar al pueblo.
He starts giving advice to the people.
Y con el tiempo,
and as the time goes by,
Absalón comienza a ganar el corazón de la gente de la ciudad.
Absalom starts to gain the heart of the people of that country.
Y empiezan a ver a este hombre, Absalón, como un gran líder.
And they start to see this man that he could become a great leader.
Y la gente venía con Absalón.
And people would come to Absalom.
La gente comenzó a seguir a Absalón.
People started to follow and cheer Absalom.
Y en el versículo 7 al 10.
And in verse 7 to 10.
Nosotros podemos encontrar la historia que pasa después con Absalón.
We are able to read the story of what happens to Absalom.
Porque Absalón planea ir a Hebrón.
So then he plans that he's going to go ahead and move over to Hebron.
Para proclamarse rey en Israel.
So he could go ahead and become king of Israel.
Y Absalón buscó a un sacerdote llamado Ahitofel.
So Absalom seeks a priest to be able to help him in this gathering.
Quien era un consejero de David.
Who was actually an advisor for King David.
Porque David quería ganar, Absalom quería ganar confianza con la gente de su padre.
Because Absalom wanted to win the trust of David's own people.
Y enviarlo al palacio para que le diera información de qué es lo que estaba pasando en palacio.
So he wanted to go ahead and gather information to see what happened in the palace.
Pero en ese momento,
but in that precise moment,
David recibe la noticia.
David receives the news
de las cosas que estaban pasando con su hijo Absalón.
Of the things that were going on with his son Absalom.
Y esta noticia David no la quería, o no, más bien no la esperaba.
So then David was not waiting for this to happen.
Que su propio hijo hoy estaba contra de él.
That his own son was now going to rebel against him.
Que su hijo había hecho una conspiración para destronar a David.
Then his own son had built this big corruption to go ahead and take the kingdom from his own father.
Porque Absalón quería apoderarse del reino.
Because Absalom wanted to take over the kingdom.
Y esto fue un golpe muy duro para David.
And this was such a hard strike against David.
Fue algo que David no pudo aguantar.
There was something that David could not bear, not handle.
Si nosotros conectamos esa historia con todo lo que viene pasando en la vida de David.
If we connect all the dots and we can see the whole story of David.
Su hija violada.
His daughter was raped.
Su hijo asesinado por un hijo de él.
His own son has assassinated one of his other sons.
Y ahora este hijo se ha rebelado contra él.
And now that son has now rebelled against him.
Así que fue un golpe muy durísimo a David.
So this was a good strike, very hard for him to deal with.
Y David estaba con su gente.
And David was with his own people.
Y ellos creían que David iba a pelear contra su hijo.
And the people believed that David was going to fight against his own son.
Pero David,
but David
decidió no enfrentarse a su hijo.
He decided not to confront his son.
Y él le dice a la gente,
and he tells the people,
abandonemos la ciudad.
He said, no, let's abandon the city, let's leave.
Vámonos de la ciudad.
He said, let's leave the city behind.
David se encuentra en una situación muy mala.
So David finds himself in a very, very difficult situation.
David entendía y él sabía esto.
David understood and he knew this.
Que si él peleaba contra su hijo,
that if he would fight against his son,
la nación se iba a dividir.
Then the nation would become divided.
Y cuando Israel estuviera dividido,
and then when the nation of David would be divided,
las demás naciones iban a venir y iban a atacar a Israel.
So then the rest of the nations would take advantage and come and destroy.
Así que David se encuentra en esta encrucijada de la vida.
So then David finds himself against the wall.
Donde va perdiendo 1-0.
Where now he's losing 1-0.
David está perdiendo 1-0 acá.
So now David's losing this game 1-0.
David no defendió bien lo que él tenía que haber defendido.
David did not defend well what he had.
Él no defendió bien su familia.
He did not defend his family.
Él no defendió bien su portería.
He did not defend his goal very well.
¿Cómo estamos nosotros defendiendo la portería?
How are we defending our own courtyard?
¿Estamos dejando que el diablo haga su jugada frente a nosotros y metiéndonos goles?
Are we allowing the devil to score in our own scores and being able to do whatever he wants in our families?
David no ordenó su defensa.
David did not organize his defense team.
Dejó que los delanteros del equipo contrario hicieran con su defensa como ellos quisieran.
He allowed the strikers to be able to come in and destroy his defense.
¿Cómo nosotros estamos manejando nuestra defensa?
How are we taking care of our defense?
¿Le dejamos estando pasar al diablo cositas? No, eso no va a pasar nada.
Oh, we allowing the devil to say, nah, that's nothing. Ah, it's okay, let the devil come in.
¿O no estamos jugando con esa pasión?
Or are we not playing with that passion?
Estamos ahí jugando, no, tranquilo, eso no me va a dañar.
Oh, well, we say, no, that's not going to invade my privacy. That's not going to do anything.
David no pudo organizar su defensa.
David was not able to organize his defense team.
Y el equipo del diablo.
And then the team of the devil.
Son jugadores astutos.
They are players. players who are very wicked.
Son sucios para jugar.
They are very wicked in their ways.
En cualquier vuelta que tú te des, te meten tu zancadilla.
Any type of goal or thing move that you try to do, they go ahead and try to trip you.
A la defensa de David.
To the defense of David.
Como dicen los comentaristas deportivos.
As the people who comment on sports would say.
Le ganaron las espaldas.
They went ahead and took over.
Y le metieron el gol.
And they went ahead and scored against David.
¿Saben lo que significa ganar la espalda cuando uno está jugando fútbol?
Do you know what it means to be able to take over one's team?
Que le pasen la pelota por arriba.
To be able to go ahead and strike over.
Y usted y el contrario corras por detrás de usted y patee a marco.
And the other person would score and you didn't even see the person score right behind you.
¿Sabes que usted tiene un pastor que es de entrenador de fútbol,
You know, you have a pastor who really likes soccer.
Y estos días, el último partido que nosotros jugamos, yo le enseñé eso a los muchachos.
In this last game that we had with the teenagers, I taught him this trick.
¿Cómo meter un gol agarrando a la defensa y al portero dormido?
Yeah, to be able to score and take over the defense team and also the goalie.
Y yo ponía a un delantero.
So I would put one of the strikers.
Jugando a espaldas de la portería.
To being able to play facing backwards to the goal.
Para recibir la pelota.
So that he could go ahead and receive the
y
ball.
Y ponía otro jugador en la banda, en la esquina, en la orilla.
And I would have another player stand on the sides.
Y ponía otro jugador enfrente.
And I would put another player in the front.
Con la pelota.
And he was the one who was holding the ball.
El que estaba enfrente ponía la pelota al que estaba de espaldas.
So then the person would go ahead and throw the ball to the person that was standing backwards.
Y lógicamente los defensas venían al que tenía la pelota de espaldas.
And it was logical for all the defense to come to the person who actually had the
pero
ball.
Pero este tenía que deshacerse la pelota mientras le llegara. Al nomás llegarle tenía que agarrar la pelota y pasarla por acá, por
and
abajo.
And that person who had the ball quickly had to move on the ball to the next player.
Y el jugador que estaba en la banda tenía que correr, agarrar la pelota en volea para disparar a marco.
And the person who was on the sidebar needed to come really quickly, grab the ball and score.
Ese es ganarle la espalda a la defensa.
That's the way that you can score on your opposing team.
A David le ganaron la espalda.
So then David, they had went ahead and take over his team.
Le violaron su hija.
They went ahead and raped his daughter.
Le mataron su hijo.
They went ahead and killed his son.
Y el que lo mató fue un hijo de él.
And the one who went ahead and killed him was his own son.
Ahora le habían hecho pedazos el medio campo.
So now his whole midfield had been destroyed.
El medio campo donde está toda la fuerza de un partido de fútbol.
And the midfield is where all of his strength is of the team.
Los mediocampistas son los que van adelante y los que vienen a defender.
The midfielders are the ones who run forward and run backwards.
Ahora David le habían ganado esas posiciones.
And now all those areas had been taken over and David had no control of
them. Su hijo había conquistado casi la mitad de su reino.
And his own son had conquered half of his own kingdom.
Y había infiltrado en el palacio de David gente que le informaran lo que estaba pasando.
And he had taken enemy people into the palace and they were informing him of what he was doing.
O sea que Absalón estaba ganándole la batalla a su hijo.
So Absalom was taking over his father's kingdom.
Ya el diablo le había metido unos goles.
Yeah, the devil had already scored a couple of goals.
Y ahora viene lo más difícil para
and
David.
Now the hardest thing for David comes.
Cuando David tenía que abandonar la ciudad.
When David now had abandoned the city.
Porque su hijo estaba cerca de la ciudad.
Because now his son was near to the city.
Y David no quería enfrentarse a su hijo.
And David did not want to fight or confront his own son.
David mejor prefirió irse de la ciudad porque no quería pelear contra su hijo.
So David decides to flee and just leave the city behind.
Yo no sé, yo he escuchado historias.
I don't know, but I've listened to stories.
Que los hijos retan a sus papás para pelear. Y peleando, hablando de cortar la cabeza.
You know that I've seen that children will challenge their own parents and fight with them.
Me imagino que para un padre eso va a ser muy difícil.
I can imagine that for a parent that is so difficult to handle.
Que su hijo le diga, mira, viejo, sal y vamos a ver quién es el campeón aquí.
For your own son or daughter to tell you, come, let's go outside and see who's going to be the champion, who's going to win.
Así estaba la vida de David.
This is the way that David's life was at this moment.
Con la situación de su hijo.
With the situation of his son.
Si nosotros nos ponemos a pensar quién era David.
If we start to, for a moment to think who David was.
Un hombre que derribaba gigantes.
A man who just took over and defeated giants.
Había dominado a todos sus enemigos.
He had taken all over his enemies. He had conquered
them. ¿Cómo no iba a poder con su hijo?
How is it possible that he could not conquer his
pero
own son?
Pero David mejor prefirió irse de la ciudad.
But David David then decided to just flee and leave the city.
Porque no quería enfrentar a su hijo.
Because he did not want to confront his own son.
Mucha gente iba a morir en esa batalla.
Too many people were going to die in this battle.
Y entonces Israel iba a quedar débil y las otras naciones iban a venir y conquistar la tierra de Israel.
So then Israel would be very weak, and then other countries would come and destroy Israel.
Así que David se lleva toda su gente que estaba con él.
So David takes all of his people that were with him, and they flee.
Para protegerlos.
To be able to protect his people.
De aquello que venía contra él.
From all this that was coming against him.
Así que David va con su grupo de gente.
So then David walks with his group of people.
Huyendo de su hijo.
And they're fleeing from his own son.
Imagínese usted, el hombre guerrero.
Can you imagine this? The man who was a warrior.
El hombre fuerte en Israel.
The man who was the strongest in Israel.
Ahora está huyendo con un grupo de gente.
And now he's fleeing with a group of people.
Y ellos.
And they.
También llevaron el arca del pacto.
They also took the ark of the covenant.
¿Sabe lo que significa o qué significaba en aquel entonces llevar el arca del pacto?
Do you remember what the ark of the covenant meant to be able to take it with you?
Llevar la presencia de Dios con ellos.
To be able to take the presence of God with them.
Ellos estaban cargando esa arca.
They were carrying that covenant.
La propia presencia de Dios en medio de ellos.
They were carrying the presence of God amongst them.
Esta arca era ese pacto que ellos habían hecho.
This ark was a covenant that they had done.
Y eso representaba estar más cerca de la presencia de
Dios.
And
this was a representation that they were closer to God's presence.
En el versículo 24 al 25.
If we go on to the verses 24 and 25.
No lo vamos a leer, pero ahí nosotros podemos encontrar.
We're not going to read it, but within those verses we can find.
Que ellos regresaron el arca del pacto a la ciudad.
That they went ahead and returned the ark of the covenant to a particular place.
¿Qué me está diciendo esto a mí cuando ellos regresan el arca del pacto?
What does that tell me when they decide to return the ark to a particular place?
Que a estas alturas del partido David había aprendido la lección.
That at this point David had now learned his lesson.
David había aprendido de aquellas situaciones que le estaban pasando en la vida.
David was now learning of those situations that his life was being confronted.
David. No trata de manipular a Dios aquí.
He doesn't try to manipulate God in anymore or any way.
En otras palabras,
in other words,
David se estaba haciendo responsable de su derrota.
He was now acknowledging his defeat.
David no se estaba valiendo de que ellos tenían el arca del pacto.
He was no longer saying, I have the covenant, the ark.
Porque
with
el pueblo de Israel cuando iba a la batalla,
because the people of Israel when they went to war,
ellos llevaban el arca del pacto cuando iban a pelear.
They would take the ark of the covenant with them when they were going to go ahead and face their enemies.
Y eso les daba la seguridad de que ellos iban a ganar esa batalla.
And that would give them the guarantee, the assurance that they were going to win that battle.
Pero David decide regresar esa arca diciendo, David.
So then David decides, no, I'm going to return the ark to its place.
Está terminado.
You know what? I've decided that David is finished, is defeated.
Me hago responsable de las cosas que han pasado.
He says, I now take responsibility of everything that has happened.
Y no sacó ventaja de eso, David.
And he no longer took advantage of this.
Así que Absalón.
So then Absalom.
Se reunió con todo su ejército.
He gathered all of his army.
Y salió a la batalla contra su padre.
And he went ahead and fought his own father.
Salió a pelear contra su padre.
So he went ahead and fought against his own father.
Y Absalón comenzó la batalla.
And Absalom decided that he would start the battle.
Y David no tuvo otra acción.
And David had no other action to be taken.
Que defenderse.
But to defend himself.
Pero David.
But David.
Dio una orden.
He gave an order.
Que no mataran a su hijo Absalón.
He said, please do not kill my son Absalom.
Vamos a pelear, pero no maten a mi hijo.
He said, we're going to fight, but do not kill my son.
Y atraparon a Absalón.
And they went ahead and captured his son.
Pero Joab.
But Joab.
Que era uno de los capitanes del ejército de David.
He was one of the captains of the army.
Dio órdenes de matar a Absalón.
He said, no, go ahead and kill Absalom.
Y la pena de David fue tan grande.
And the sadness of David, his grief was so big.
Porque había perdido los primeros 45 minutos del partido de la vida.
Because he had already lost his first 45 minutes of his match of this game.
David.
David.
Había perdido.
He had lost.
1-0.
He was now losing 1-0.
¿Cómo está su equipo?
How is your team, church?
¿Está capaz para poderle presentar batalla al equipo contrario?
Are they ready to be able to face the enemy?
¿O está débil como algunas selecciones que hemos visto jugar en Brasil?
Or is some of your team weak, like some of the teams that we've seen playing in the World Cup?
¿O están preparados en la fe para defenderla?
Or is your team ready with faith to be able to defend?
Porque si nosotros no estamos preparados para pelear el partido de la vida,
because if we are not ready to fight the game of our life,
el diablo nos va a dejar 11-1 como dejó El Salvador hace unos años atrás en España 82.
Then the devil's going to leave you defeated with a terrible score against you.
Nunca ha habido otra goleada en mundiales que esa.
There has never been another type of delivery of that kind.
Olvidémonos nosotros del mundial, olvidémonos de la pelota. ¿Cómo está nuestra vida?
Okay, let's forget about soccer, let's forget about the World Cup. Really, church, how is your personal life with God?
¿Estamos listos para pelear contra el enemigo?
Are we ready to fight the enemy where we stand now?
¿Estamos nosotros preparados para ganar esta partida de la vida?
Are we ready to win this battle against the enemy?
¿Cómo estamos?
How are we?
¿Está débil o está fuerte nuestro espíritu?
Are you strong or is your spirit weak?
¿O es nuestra alma más fuerte que nuestro espíritu y nuestra fe flaquea?
Or is our weapon stronger than our own faith and our faith is weakened every day?
¿Cómo está?
How is it?
Que si le dice el doctor, mire, usted le quedan 3 años de vida, ¿qué haría usted?
So what would happen if the doctor says you have 3 more years to live? What would happen to you? What would you do?
O que le diga a su jefe, mira, usted ya no tiene más trabajo aquí.
Or if your boss tells you know what, forget it, you no longer have a job here in this company.
O que le diga a su esposo, mira, ya no quiero más contigo nada.
Or if your husband tells you know what, forget it, I'm done. This is it. We're finished.
O que sus hijos se le vayan y lo dejen ahí a usted.
Or if your children fly away, leave you and say forget it, and you're left alone.
Y nos sintamos flaquear en esas situaciones.
And in that moment we feel weak.
¿Cómo está nuestra vida?
How is our life before
¿Estamos
the Lord?
Preparados para ganar, para pelear por la mejor competencia?
Are we ready to fight our the best game of
pelear
our life?
Por nuestra fe.
Are you ready to fight for your own faith?
Pelear por nuestra salvación.
Are you ready to fight for your own salvation?
O nos vamos a rendir y vamos a perder al cualquier
ataque. Are you
going
to surrender and give it all to the devil to take away from you?
Hay cristianos que se vencen fácilmente.
You know there's Christian believers that are defeated very easily.
El diablo los vence fáciles.
The devil destroys them so easy.
Le mete goles.
It scores goals on them constantly.
Quedan desmayados.
They go ahead and pass out.
Oh, ya no quiero ir a la iglesia.
Oh, no, I don't want to go to church anymore.
Golazo.
There's another goal that just got scored.
No, ya no quiero servir en la iglesia. Me siento desanimado. Golazo te metieron.
Oh, I don't want to serve in church. I don't want to give my service. Another goal the devil just scored.
Gol olímpico te metieron.
They went ahead and scored this incredible goal against you right now.
De un tiro de corner te metieron la pelota a la portería.
You know, from the corner they went ahead and scored into your goalie.
De tiro libre de 50 metros te metieron el gol.
They scored an incredible goal against you right now.
¿Cómo está nuestra vida?
How are you? How's your life
Estamos
before the Lord?
¿Estamos ejercitados para enfrentar las batallas de la vida?
Are you ready to face this war in your life?
Porque nosotros decimos, no, tranquilo, yo nunca he tenido problemas. Mire, la vida está llena de problemas.
Because people are so peaceful and say, nah, don't worry, I have no problems
in life. Todo tipo de problemas.
But life is full of problems.
Algunos rojos, otros negros, azules, verdes.
We have problems, red, blue, every color you can find.
De los colores que usted le quiera poner.
Any color that you wish to put on your problem.
Así está la vida.
This is the way life is now.
Esas son las batallas que nosotros peleamos.
These are the battles that we fight constantly.
Esas son los partidos que nosotros jugamos.
These are the games that we play constantly.
Estamos en un partido.
We're in a game.
No la hemos ganado todavía.
We have not won yet.
Estamos en los primeros 45 minutos.
We're just starting in our first 45 minutes of the match.
¿Cómo va su score? ¿Cómo va su, cómo le llaman? ¿Cómo va su, cómo le dicen, futboleros? Hombre, ayúdenme.
And you know, what is the score up now? What is your score now?
¿Cómo va su marcador?
How's your scoreboard going right now? How's your scoreboard?
3-0.
Is it 3-0?
11-1.
Oh, is the devil winning 11-1?
0-0, pastor.
Oh, is it 0-0, pastor, actually?
O 1-0.
Oh, is it 1-0?
¿Cómo está su marcador?
How is your scoreboard now?
Depende cuántas zancadillas le ha echado el diablo y cuántos goles le ha tirado.
It depends how many times the devil has defeated you or how many things the devil has conquered over.
Esta historia de David.
So this story of David.
El gran campeón.
The great champion.
El gran conquistador.
Oh, the great conqueror.
El gran guerrero.
The great warrior.
Lo llevan 1-0 en esta historia.
He is now faced 1-0.
Va a 1-0.
His scoreboard is 1-0.
Va perdiendo.
He's losing.
David al final de todo.
So then at the end, David.
Con toda esa pena encima.
With all of that sadness. Within him.
A pesar de su dolor.
Besides all the pain that he was feeling.
Y la incertidumbre que había sobre él.
And all this great grief that he felt.
Él rehusó.
He refused.
A condicionar su fe en Dios.
To be able to condition to his own performance, his faith.
Pasara lo que pasara.
He said it doesn't matter what happens.
David. Aceptó la voluntad de Dios.
He accepted God's will.
¿Qué hay que hacer para ganar en este juego de la vida?
So what do we need to do to be able to win this game?
Debemos de apoyarnos en Dios.
We need to be able to go ahead and support ourselves or find comfort in God.
No es nada fácil, pero es lo mejor.
It is not the easiest, but we need to rely on God.
¿Sabe cuando usted y yo llegamos a ese punto de decir?
When we get to the point and we say,
Señor, haz mejor lo que te parezca en mi vida.
And we finally said, God, you know what? Forget it. Do
algo,
what you please.
Algo pasa en nosotros.
Then something really happens within us.
Si usted quiere ganar el juego de la vida,
if you want to win the game of your life,
acepte la voluntad de Dios y decir, Señor,
you need to then accept and say, God,
algo conmigo.
He said, do whatever you want with me and accept God's will on your
eso
life.
Eso es lo que hizo David.
That's what David did.
David, al regresar el arca del pacto,
when David decided to return the Ark of the Covenant to its place,
estaba aceptando,
he was then accepting,
la voluntad de Dios,
God's will for his personal life.
Aunque estaba perdiendo 1-0.
Although he was losing 1-0.
Pero aceptó la voluntad de Dios.
But he accepted God's will in his life.
Hoy en esta tarde yo quiero invitarte a una cosa.
So this afternoon I really just want to invite you to one thing.
Que examines tu vida.
I want you to really examine your personal life.
¿Cómo está tu vida?
How is your life?
¿Cómo está?
How is your life?
¿Cómo está tu fe?
How is your faith?
¿Está flaqueando tu fe?
Is your faith weakened?
No hay interés por las cosas de Dios.
Is there no interest for God's particular things? How is it?
Porque este juego.
Because this game.
El juego de la vida.
The game of your life.
No es un juego simple.
It is not a simple game.
Se trata de dónde vas a pasar la eternidad.
It's all about where you're going to spend the rest of eternity.
Y si estás jugando ese juego demasiado débil,
and if you're playing this game called life on a very weak spot,
el diablo te puede ganar.
The devil's gonna win.
Y puede llevarte a otro lugar que el cual no quisiera estar.
And it's gonna take you to a place that you don't want to be at, but he will take you there.
En esta tarde me gustaría que cada uno de ustedes examinara su corazón.
So this afternoon I'd like for everybody to examine their own personal heart.
Y se preguntara cómo está su relación con Dios.
I'm sorry, I want you to ask yourself, how is your personal life with the Lord?
¿Cómo está su relación con Dios?
How is your relationship with the Lord?
¿Hay un compromiso con Dios o no lo hay?
Is there a commitment with God or there isn't one?
¿Hay un respeto hacia las cosas de Dios o no las hay?
Do you respect the things that belong to the Lord or you just don't care and don't respect?